All right, folks, today we're going to be taking out a tree. What we're going to be using are basic tools. This is a electric sawzall with the Diablo blade. The sawzall is made by Ryobi. You can pick these up at Home Depot for about $69, and the blades cost about $5 a piece. So here's a view of the tree we're going to be pulling out. Plug in my cord here. And tie a little knot so that it don't come unplugged on me. Alright, so here's the first cut. Cuts real quick, the thin stuff. All these cuts are in real time. Nothing sped up here. This is how long it takes. These saw blades are really aggressive. You don't even have to even run the saw, you could just saw it like an old fashioned saw without squeezing the trigger, and it cut almost just as quick. But it just makes it that much easier just to use the trigger. So I got the tree stripped down, basically. That all took about 15 minutes. Here's me cutting one of the thicker pieces where you probably should have used a chainsaw, but this isn't too bad. It took me, what was that, 15 seconds to get through that thick piece of the tree there. And that's about the limit. I mean, you really don't want to be cutting anything any thicker than that with this. You'll just be hacking at it forever. Alright, so right now I'm digging a trench around the tree, and I'm going to be cutting all the roots underneath it. Alright, this took me about an hour to get to this point. You know, I dug all the way around the tree, cut all the main roots, and cut the smaller roots that are hidden under the big roots. Like, a lot of times you'll find that there's a big root right here, and there'll be smaller roots underneath it that are hidden by this one. This tree had about three main roots just like this one here, and I don't know, I cut through it pretty quick. You can see a little smoke coming off my blade there, because it's starting to show that it's worn out a little more than it was before. So here's me prying that root out of the ground. Let me move my saw here so I don't damage it. Little muscle here to pull up the root. And this way I don't have all these roots running into the ground. Now if I were to use a stump grinder, and it may have been easier, but then again, I don't know, because there'd be wood chips everywhere. I guess you could just make them part of the soil. Okay, here's the chicken. All right, so I always try and leave the tree at least 4 foot tall. That tree trunk is gonna act like a lever. That's all leverage for my truck. If I were to cut this tree all the way down to the ground, it'd be three times as hard for my truck to pull that tree out of the ground. Leaving that 4 foot is like adding a breaker bar to the tree stump. It makes it that much easier to pull out. Alright, here we go. Start her up. Swing her around to the neighbor's driveway. Everyone's freaking out like, "Hey, did you ask the neighbors for permission?" I'm like, "No, I just hurried up and did it before you came here. Yeah, I'm not gonna bother them to ask if I can do something real quick in the driveway. Whereas they wouldn't notice anyway." Okay, so pulling out this tree, I did have to use the 4x4 mow. One thing you can do is just put it in reverse, rev up the engine a little bit, hit that tree stump with some speed, and that would be less wear and tear in your truck because you're not using your drivetrain, you just weighted a truck. I just put it in 4x4 low and just use the drivetrain and make it basically cut free. But it did need to be in 4x4 low. Another thing is I don't really like to use those nylon straps, those recovery straps. If that's all you have, you may be okay if it don't have the hooks on it, because those hooks are just weight that can fling back at you. I've actually seen with the nylon straps, people go and hit them with the weight of the vehicle, and the tree stumps, I've seen tree stumps break loose and go flying through the air because of the, it's like yanking a stump out of the ground with a rubber band. So here's me getting my dolly, because that stump is like 300 pounds. I couldn't carry it myself. It was hard for me to get the dolly to lean over with that stump on it. It was that heavy. It took all my body weight to get the stump with the dolly. And I weighed 200 pounds, so. Oh, there we go. There it is. I got it. Let me tell you, this tree stump was hard to roll. It was very heavy. Alright, now here we go, rolling up the driveway. I could feel the weight pulling me back down the driveway. And the tires were like halfway flat just from the weight. Alright, YouTube, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. And do me a favor, like, comment, subscribe. I like to hear what you think. Alright, have a great day.